part two of the roof repair video. If you didn't see the other video, go check it out before you start to attempt this. I am all ready to put paneling up, but you may not be if you're just starting to look at this video, so definitely go check that out. Got my hair up, no hat on, so you know that means business. So let's get started. First thing is first, I went ahead and marked all my trusses on the sides over here. That way we have a good point from A to B where we can string the chalk line and we'll know exactly where we need to put our staples. So after you have done that,
I like to use a piece of
paper and a pencil. And I'm going to tell you this again for the people that don't listen to me and don't hear it, because I'm going to keep saying it. Work in 4-foot sections. Why would I do that? Why would I work in 4-foot sections?
Because a piece of plywood is 4 feet by 8 feet. And you're going to get the most
seamless look if you work in 4-foot sections, because you'll have 4-foot piece, 4-foot piece, 4-foot piece,
another 4-foot piece. And then you can put some nice trim in the middle
to cover up the joining pieces of plywood, and it looks really nice and clean. So what I did is I technically had 6 feet of roof that really needed to be replaced. I went out an extra 2 feet to the next part of the ceiling and just
took it all down, and
that way I have a nice clean truss to work with, and I have an even 8 feet,
and I can put 2 pieces of plywood right up on the roof
and it'll be perfect. So
I'm gonna get my tools here. This is the best thing
you're gonna have when it comes to putting up paneling. So go ahead and draw yourself a square or a rectangle. I already measured from A to B. So from length
should be 92.5, and it is. And then I already know
it's gonna be 4 feet. So to start out, I need to cut a piece of, you can either use
quarter inch paneling or
eighth inch paneling,
quarter inch plywood.
I prefer quarter inch plywood just because it's thicker and it doesn't really
sag in the middle
of the ceiling like the paneling would,
because the paneling is only 1/8 inch. So
before I cut,
I don't know if you guys can see this or not, but you see all these
wires hanging down here. I like to make a little map of where these wires are going to be on my sheet.
Work one sheet at a time,
and I'm going to start towards the inside of the camper and work my way to the back, because if there is an imperfection at the back, I can cover it up with some trim. If one of my paneling isn't on perfectly straight, you're not going to be able to tell anyway, because it's going to have trim on there. So I've got a speaker wire right here in my hand. I have the thermostats. I have some lights over here and back there. I have the slide out wires right here. And
that's pretty much it for right there. So
I kind of like to turn around and draw it facing the direction that I'm going to be putting it up. So you see I have my rectangle. Put
92.5 by 4 feet.
Okay.
So
you measure from one side of the wall in, and then you measure from a truss, or from your first truss over. So let's say I want to do,
these lights right here. Okay, so let me make
sure my 4 foot ends
on this truss right here. So it's within the sheet of plywood that I'm going to be working in.
So what you
do is you measure from the center of one truss over to kind of where the light is going to be. So that's roughly about 40 inches. And then you measure from the wall.
Pick one wall and measure from the same wall. So 40 inches
by
about 32 inches.
So
I'm looking this direction.
see what I did here? Okay. 40 by 32. Now you do the same thing for your speaker. You do the same thing for your AC. And you measure all from the same side and then put your dimensions. That way you know exactly where you need to drill a hole. So, I have done that. And for these two wires right here, the slide out and the thermostat, I'm actually going to move them and I'm going to put them in the center right here because I'm going to build an entertainment center where I'm standing. So I want the wires to come out into the entertainment center and not be like, I don't want to have to build something just to cover up the wires in the entertainment center. So since I've already got the panels off, I'm just going to move them over. So I'll just drill them a hole in the new place and then drop the wires down in. So I want it somewhere in the middle is 48. Okay, and then I have another. I have these two right here. So these are going to be circles.
And you can do this any way you want. Whatever way makes sense to you is how you can do it. I'll show you my paper when I'm
done, though. So. This one is 12 by 52.
This one is going to be 8.5 by 61,
and then 12 by 52. Okay, so you see what I did here?
This is the speaker and the AC vent right there. So I put circles because I'm going to end up routing this out. So that's just not electrical. And then these two are just kind of smaller holes that I need. I'll probably make them all the same size just to make sure I'm in the right spot. But you see, you know, this one is this X 32 by 40. You see I use the same side. I use this side and this side. And then after you take your measurements and you double check, pretty much just go cut them out. So, let's start with that, and I'll take you guys with me. Get my tape measure.
Glasses, wherever I put them, I don't know. I'd have some more in the garage. Oh, there they are.
Wood. one thing I was thinking about while I went over there, I'm going to go check my roof over here
to see if it's better to use the quarter inch or the paneling, because
normally I have replaced the entire roof, so it didn't matter, but I don't want there to be a weird gap between, so I'm going to go check to see which one I need to use.
Be right back.
I think I can use quarter inch and get away with it. Maybe a little lip, but I can sand it down. It's not a big deal. This is my saw guide. I like to use it for the big panels because it just makes a cleaner cut, and I think it looks better. So, use that. So you can see the whole sheet. There we go. I have marked 92.5, and then I have marked 90 because there's 1.5 inches on my circular saw, so we have to account for that. Everybody should be about 1.5 inches. My glasses are like ready walkers here. Should be about 1.5 inches, but if not, just measure the distance between your blade and the guide on your circular saw. Right here.
cut your sheet upside down, because when you cut that looks like that. So if you cut it upside down, that's going to be on the underside. Okay. So now that we have that, we drill our holes. When you think of your panel, it's going to go up in the ceiling just like this. So you're going to go ahead and measure your holes, your light fixtures. So I need one that is 40. Check this to make sure I did it right. 40 by 32, and a hole saw. Saw from before, so I'm just gonna get it out real quick. And then where you have your X's, just get a small hole saw and drill a hole. you can see this, but I did not go all the way through. I just went enough with the hole saw to where the bit goes through the other side. Now I'm going to flip it over and I'm going to finish the hole saw. That way the edges aren't jagged. Go back in the camper and do a little test fit. So I'm gonna bring you guys in and then I'm gonna bring the panel in. We'll do a little test fit and make adjustments as needed. So I'm gonna stick you guys all the way back here. That way hopefully you can see me. Sorry about all the mess. Okay, yeah, that's pretty good. I'm gonna have those wires coming right here. That is where that is. And that wire come right there. Okay. So I got it right. So, 9 times out of 10, that will not happen. You will have to go back and recut and adjust. I shouldn't say 9 times out of 10. I should say, I don't know, a lot of times. Especially if it's with the ceiling, it's a lot easier. But if it's with a wall and funny corners and stuff like that, you're probably going to need to go back and adjust and, you know, just take a little bit off at a time. Don't try to do anything dramatic because then you'll ruin perfectly good sheet of wood. And you don't want to do that. So, let me go out here. Next thing is we can put it on the ceiling. So, I'm going to plug in my compressor. This little crap thing down here. You guys can see that. I'm going to show you. I bought a new one. But I haven't
wired it yet or plugged it in yet. Because I gotta bolt it to the ground, but this is money, baby. Right here. This is it, right here. My husband laughed at me when I brought it home because I got it in the truck by myself. Very excited. 60 gallon. It's gonna be so nice not having that little dinky thing out there. I can put a hose reel right up here and just kind of extend my hose out there. So, yeah. All right, so I'm gonna put you guys right here. I'm gonna plug my compressor in, and then I'm gonna get some tools, and we're gonna start. So hang on just a second.
is in your way. Hopefully you can still see. Make sure you'll be able to run your electrical through. I'm gonna take these wires. Actually,
yeah, I'm gonna take these wires off. All right. Sorry, I was thinking. My phone is right there.
So instead, normally I would take a picture of this
and
just kind of take them off one
at a time.
But because I don't have my phone, I'm just going to clip them and keep them that way.
So if I can find my things. Again, telling you, this is half my life, y'all.
Half my life is literally looking
for tools that I have misplaced. That's what it is.
Okay, and before you cut any wires, please make sure that your camper is unplugged and the battery is unplugged. You don't want
to short anything out. So, ta-da!
That can come off.
So I'll just save this, and I can... I probably don't even need it. These should feed through.
Okay.
Where is... So basically what you're going to do is you're going to take your liquid nails and you're going to run it along
your trusses. It kind of just gives it an extra little something-something to keep it on. So...
You don't have to use a lot.
Just kind of a bead.
Cross it. And this stuff is pretty... pretty good. Don't have to put it all along the last one because that is where you're going to be smushing up another piece of paneling against it. And I saw some
staples here that I forgot.
This must have been from the one that I took out. Let me go get my helper, and we can stick this panel up.
Yep.
All right, be right back. basically, once you get the panel up,
you're going to start from your edges, go around, and then you can get
your middle. When you flip it up,
you're going to want to stick your wires through.
That way they don't get caught up in the ceiling. There. Wondering what I forgot.
It's the antenna that's sticking out. I forgot to draw a hole for that. Draw a hole for it. Okay.
probably around here somewhere. Normally, I have a chalk line that I string from my marker right here all the way over to my mark on the other side, but I can't find my chalk line. I don't know where it is. So, you saw I just grabbed a piece of wood and eyeballed it, and I've done this so much that it was right, and I lined up with the truss. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. One of my wires didn't fit through here. It didn't reach. So, I'll just make this hole a little bigger, and I'll bring out that other wire and extend it down here, add some new wire to it. But here is my speaker wire right there. This is the hole for the air conditioning vent. This is a light right here. Let's see. Yep. Oof. I got some bugs climbing up the wall here. I don't know what the heck that one is. But anyway, you can basically see, you know, it lined up with the truss right there. Looks really good. I'm happy with it. So the next step is to basically do the same thing, but for over here. So we'll go cut another sheet to 92.5. And then after that, the only hole I need to mark is this one right here for the corner, because it doesn't look like, there's a vent right here, I think. Yep. All right, so there's a vent right here. So we will put a hole for that vent in too, and we'll call it a day after that, because I don't have the air conditioner in yet. And it's really hot in here. You can't tell. So I'm not going to do a video of that, because it's basically the same process. I'm just doing it over again, and my phone's on 10%, and it's about to die. So if you guys have more questions, please let me know. And I can try to answer them the best I can, or if there's something else you want to see, just let me know. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you guys have a good rest of your day.